Welcome back, everyone. If you're having trouble losing weight, it might not be a matter of willpower or motivation. Maybe it's your timing.
Research shows how you can organize your day to maximize your weight loss. And morning anchor Anita Blanton has the new tricks to trimming down. It's all new at 5.
Not to say you don't need anything else, but you're going to see this is really simple yet very important information. Sticking to a routine will give you a huge boost in your battle of the bulge.
It turns out the best thing to do when you wake up in the morning is to weigh yourself. Since the average American wakes up around 6:30 a.m., we'll start our clocks there. Make sure your stomach is empty and hop on a scale. It's the lightest you'll be all day.
People weigh themselves at tracking what they're doing in life. They're responsible and accountable to what they're doing, so they tend to lose weight more often.
So think of it as setting yourself up for success. 5 minutes later, time to feel the burn. Exercising in the morning makes you burn off fat even before you start putting food into your mouth. Now at 7:30, breakfast should be served. Doctors say this is the most important tip to pay attention to if you really want to lose weight. Research shows this is the first natural time of the day that people get hungry.
If you don't pay attention to your natural circadian rhythm of meal eating, then you'll get hungry. And what happens when people get hungry? They do foolish things.
Shrug off the urge, you'll likely eat more throughout the day. But if you get a good breakfast in, a vitally important, fiber-rich pre-lunch snack should come at 11:45. It'll fill your stomach up, keep you full longer, and it should help you eat around 70 calories less at lunch 15 minutes later. Then, use the same trick before your 6:30 dinner time.
10 p.m., your melatonin levels will be at their highest, and that's when you should go right to sleep. Keep in mind, things like TVs and computers will fight that urge to sleep, increasing your cravings for carbohydrates. Anita Blanton, Eyewitness News 5.